By every measure, we won the debate easily last night.
While President Donald Trump declared himself the winner of Tuesday's chaotic debate,
we won the debate by almost every poll that I saw.
His Democratic rival Joe Biden had a different view.
The president of the United States conducting himself the way he did, I think it was just a national embarrassment.
Whatever your view, the 90-minute showdown faced widespread criticism Wednesday, including from Trump's fellow Republicans in the Senate and its majority leader.
Well, let me just say with the debate, it was not Lincoln Douglas.
Senator Mitt Romney, who has clashed with Trump in the past, did not approve.
I thought it was an embarrassment last night, the debate.
Republican senators facing re-election, including Susan Collins and John Cornyn, offered more nuanced criticisms.
I think that the interrupting on both sides, the name-calling, was very unbecoming for a presidential debate.
Would that, too much of our politics are personality-driven, and I don't think that serves the public interest.
Should the president have more forcefully denounced white supremacists?
Yes.
The group that manages the presidential debate said on Wednesday it would take steps to bring order to the next two that are scheduled, saying, quote, last night's debate made clear that additional structure should be added to the format of the remaining debates to ensure a more orderly discussion of the issues, adding that it was, quote, carefully considering the changes that it will adopt and will announce those measures shortly. The Trump campaign accused the group, which is nonpartisan, of, quote, moving the goalposts and changing the rules in the middle of the game. At his campaign stop in Ohio, Biden said that he hoped organizers of future debates would be able to turn off the microphone of the candidate who is not supposed to be speaking.
This next debate is going to be in front of real live people. It's going to be a town hall. And I just hope we're able to. I'm looking forward to it. And I hope we're able to get a chance to actually answer the questions that are asked.
According to preliminary data, the first debate likely attracted a much smaller television audience than the record set 4 years ago when Trump debated then-rival Hillary Clinton, though more data was due to be released later on Wednesday.